in this Into the Outdoors at Home edition.
Public lands are an important piece of wetland conservation, but public land alone can't sustain duck populations. Rocco taught us how important the Central Flyway region is for ducks. And a large part of the Central Flyway is the Prairie Potholes region.
What is the Prairie Potholes region?
The Prairie Potholes region is a unique mix of grasslands and wetlands that stretches across Canada and the United States border to Montana, North and South Dakota, Minnesota, and ends in Iowa and Nebraska. This region was formed 10,000 years ago as the glaciers melted and left these shallow pools of water. Now these wetlands are home to hundreds of species of wildlife.
Sounds like this region is pretty important for wildlife. That must mean it's protected through funding from hunting licenses, right?
Well, yes and no. A large part of this region is protected by conservation efforts, but also a large part of this region is owned by private landowners.
Okay, so what does conservation look like on private land?
That's a great question. Let's head back to South Dakota to take a look at what private organizations, like Ducks Unlimited, are doing to help preserve private wetland habitats.
My name is Randy Meidinger. I'm a regional biologist with Ducks Unlimited. Been working with the DU for about 20 years now. So the Prairie Pothole region is just a very, very diverse landscape with the mix of grasslands, uplands, and wetlands interspersed. The species richness, there's hundreds of different birds, grassland birds, shorebirds, waterbirds, ducks, game birds, mammals, deer, and amphibians. It's just incredible. There's an equal amount of grass and forb species out there. There's hundreds of different species of forbs out here as well.
It sounds like wetlands are full of wildlife, but why are they so important for ducks?
The shallow wetlands are really important for ducks to get the aquatic invertebrates early in the year to the where they can get the insects they need to create their clutches. And as the hens incubate their eggs and hatch the clutches, the more seasonal type wetlands that are a little bit deeper, those have warmed up enough where there's a lot of bugs and stuff for the broods to take off.
Sounds like a really healthy ecosystem to me. So what's the catch?
So some of the threats to the landscape out here, the wetlands and the grassland, are tillage, plowing up native prairie sod, and draining of the wetlands.
With growing populations, farmers are expected to produce more crops so that you and I have food to eat. But some of these farming practices can hurt the native wetlands. We need the farms and we need the wetlands.
So how can we have both?
A good place to start is to identify what farmers, ranchers, conservationists, and wildlife all have in common. They all have a shared interest in grass and water. Farmers and ranchers need them to support their crops and livestock. Conservationists want to protect it for the sake of environment and wildlife. Wildlife relies on grass and water for their food and shelter. So it's important to make sure that grass and water are managed properly so that everyone can continue to utilize these great resources.
I'm Brad Schmidt. I'm the regional agronomist with DU, and I've been at DU for about 2 years now. What we see is a lot of conventional tillage. So we see a lot of black dirt that's tilled up annually, every fall and every spring. When we do that, is we're treating our soils almost like a catastrophic event because we have microbes and fungi and everything that are living in that soil that help us transfer nutrients to plants and bring up water to plants, everything like that. So when we go through and do these tillage events, what we're doing is it's a natural disaster to that soil.
Soil is full of microscopic life called microbes. These are things living in the soil that are so small that you need a microscope to see them. These microbes, such as bacteria, are essential for the health of the soil and the plants. Since plants are rooted in soil, they rely on the soil around them to provide the nutrients they need to live and grow. These tiny bacteria live on or inside live plant roots and can help the plant absorb nutrients. They even protect the plant from disease or drought. However, when the soil is tilled, the live plant roots that the bacteria were living on are ripped up. Without a home, these bacteria die and the health of the soil is depleted, so it's harder to grow the crops we need for food.
We're all connected with soil because every single thing that we need to survive, food, air, and water, all originates from the soil. So if we're not taking care of the soil, and thinking about soil first, we as humans, and it's not even just the ducks that aren't gonna have existence anymore, it's gonna be us as well. Because I think one thing that we forget about is, you know, us humans are not invisible. We're an animal just like everything else is. So we have to think about what we're doing in this world that's gonna impact for generations to come.
From a wildlife habitat standpoint, wetlands are very important. It's also important to recognize that wetlands play a vital role in things like improving water quality. They're great filters to improve the quality of water that flows through a wetland. They can help with flood control, and wetlands and recharge the groundwater, which is very important here. And they're also just great places to go and recreate.
That's right. Not only do wetlands help improve water quality and protect against floods, they also act as a carbon sink. That means that they store carbon from the atmosphere by holding it in their plants and in their soil. Holding a lot of carbon helps restore the soil's health. This can help lead to better crop growth, resistance from drought, and even protection against erosion.
Who would have thought that dirt played such a big role in keeping our planet healthy?
I mean, that is one of our huge priorities and goals, is to help educate our urban consumers and recreators how important what we do in managing grasslands is. And I think the younger generation has grown to appreciate where their food comes from. Water quality, carbon sequestration, and it's all important, and there isn't anything does it any better than well-managed grasslands.
Well, there you have it. Wetland habitats aren't just important for waterfowl and other wildlife, they're also important for us too. That's why it's so important to continue protecting wetland habitats on both private and public land, so that we can preserve this environment for future generations.
Yeah, you're totally right. These habitats aren't just weeds and puddles, they're actually full of life. And I admit, it has been pretty cool learning about wetlands and conservation with you today. And you know what? You should try visiting a wetland habitat next time you head
into the outdoors.